Good morning, everyone. Miles Austin here with you on the session number eight. Session number eight for fire starters. I'm looking forward today to talk to a guy as I've reversed the roles a little bit. Today, for the first time, I get to interview Kelly rather than the other way around, because every Monday at what time, Kelly?
3 o'clock Central, 1 o'clock Pacific.
There we go. Every Monday, we have a podcast and a blab called Biz Locker Radio. And Kelly has guests every week that are in business and successful thought leaders across the spectrum. And I do a small segment called X's and O's, and he interviews me about whatever the new tool of the week is that we're talking about. So today, I get to reverse it and ask you the questions. The difference, Kelly, is I only ask you two questions, and I'm going to shut up and let you just go from there, buddy.
You're not going to give me a hard time either, like I do you, right?
Oh, of course not. You know me. I'm all buttoned down serious. So thanks, bud. Thank you for doing this, and thanks you for joining us today. Kelly, here's the question this whole series is based around, and share with our listeners and the people that will hear this on audio in the days and the weeks ahead. How do you start your day? What kind of routine? What processes? What is it that you follow on a regular, hopefully day-to-day basis, that you use to start your day, get you off on the right foot, and help you have the success that you've having? It's all yours, buddy.
Well, it's a really great question. I've been really excited to do these and to see what you're doing with various people, because I know it varies from one person to the next. For me, the mornings are the time that if I get them started right, as most people do, I'm sure, Miles, then it makes the day quite different. For me, it's a time to spend time doing a couple of things. I get to spend time with my wife. Typically, we get up in the morning and we go to our coffee machine and we get a big cup of coffee and we'll spend time together alone. It's a time that we really set aside to talk and to talk about what's going on and really not just day-to-day activities, but to have those deeper conversations about things. My wife and I are Christians, and we spend a lot of time in daily Bible study as time allows. With my schedule, sometimes it's difficult, but we embark on a regular basis on a daily devotional reading. And it's that time when we get to talk about those things and talk into each other's lives. And like a lot of men, I'm sure, I mean, I married way over my head, and I married a lady that I have tremendous amount of respect for. And she just, it means so much to me in starting my day and then just keeping me full all the time in terms of what she has to say. It's just a really good time for me to kind of settle in and settle down. And, you know, she's such a great sounding board, Miles, when I'm struggling or when issues are popped up or when I'm having a particular challenge at work. She's a great sounding board, someone who really listens and offers a perspective that I have a tremendous amount of respect for. So it's a great time for us. Typically 30, 40 minutes in the morning. And when it's nice here in Oklahoma, we're out on the back patio with that cup of coffee, enjoying, you know, the morning. And it's really fantastic. And I find, you know, I grew up in a time in the sales business when Zig Ziglar said, you are who you are and where you are because of what you put in your mind. And my morning ritual was always one of reading and spending time reading. And I'm a voracious reader. So a lot of that time is first thing in the morning. I've got a stack of books and I'm working down through them and reading them. Later in life, that reading time became more about the daily devotion and spending time doing that. So that's always been a part of what I've done since I was a young man. But there's a man named Dan Clark that we had on BizLocker Radio some months ago, you may recall. And I once heard him say that you're the average of the five people you spend the most time with. And I found that to be profound. And I found that the more time I spent with the most important person in my life, my wife, the real impact that it had on my daily demeanor and my attitude and the way I felt about the rest of the day.
Well, that's interesting. I remember when he mentioned that on the call and on the podcast. And because for me, I thought about that. And I thought, you know, the five people I hang around with are my two dogs, the barista at Safeway, the gas station attendant, and the post office guy. I mean, so I bark a little bit more than normal, and I drink way too much coffee. So, no, bud, look, that's great. I'm envious, honestly. What a great way to start your morning and to have that focus. Are you an early morning kind of guy, or what time does your day start?
You know, I wouldn't call myself an early morning guy, and I'll tell you why. When I was a young man, I actually worked in high school and college at a grocery store, and I worked the all-night shift. So I was, the guy that put up groceries and all that kind of thing, and we worked all night. And I kind of developed the habit of being awake and alert at night and not so much in the morning. I'd come home, and morning was the time to crash. And I guess maybe that was natural for me then, because my natural rhythm is not to be an early morning guy, but my wife is, which is really remarkable. It makes it easy for her. She's the one, and thank God for that. She pops up in the morning, and she gets the coffee ready. I'm selling her short because we don't go get coffee together. She brings me a cup of coffee because she knows that I need that to get rolling. But, you know, as my career has progressed, I respond based on what I have to do. So if I've got to be traveling early, I'm up early. If I don't have to be up somewhere and be there early, then I'm still up at a reasonable time, you know, somewhere between 6 and 7 o'clock. And doing what I normally do. But I tell you, as I've gotten later in life, now an added part of that daily morning piece, and one of the reasons I need to get up early, is I spend probably 15 or 20 minutes stretching every morning. You know, as we get older, things tend not to work as well as they used to. So I spent a lot of time, recently had a few issues with my back. And so I'm spending a lot of time in stretching and making sure things are still malleable.
Yeah. I'm just offended that you said we are getting older. I don't know who in the heck the other we is in the room here, but
no, Miles, you passed older several years ago.
Yes, I did, my friend. Yes, I did. So, okay, so you've gotten up, your wife's drug you out of bed, you've had your coffee, you've had that opportunity to just sit and really talk and kind of, you know, get settled in for the day. What do you do next? I mean, when the day, okay, you've done all that and you're in the right mindset, then Kelly, do you go right to email? Do you have a calendar? I mean, how do you actually jump in and start doing your business activities?
Well, one of the things that I think perhaps I do a little differently than some, not certainly not everyone, and maybe not even most, but one of the things that I do differently is my morning starts the night before. I do a lot of my preparation the evening before. So, you know, I've done a lot of work getting ready for what goes on that morning. You know, I've prepared the materials. I've reviewed materials. If I'm working with a client that day or that morning or multiple clients, I've got those things laid out. So those things are prepared and I'm ready to go. I know what I'm doing when I do get out of bed. And there's a certain amount of comfort that's associated with that. So that makes it nice. So the next thing typically I'm doing now in this age of social media is I find that my go-to is to go to LinkedIn. I want to find out who's doing what. And again, being a reader, I'm typically reading a dozen articles in the morning or skimming at least a dozen articles in the morning from people that I know and trust and have connections with in our group and in other groups that I'm affiliated with. And I find that keeps me up to speed. That's sort of an extension of what I did as a sales guy. My objective as a sales guy was to be current and up to speed and have a pretty broad based knowledge, Miles, so that I could talk to any prospect or customer intelligently about what was going on. So I'm spending time checking the news and reviewing what's happened in the sports world and the business world, looking at, the journal or something like that. So I have a really good sense of what's going on today, because inevitably what happens, the conversation starters with customers and clients is you roll in, the first thing they'll say is, hey, did you notice or did you see or what do you think about X or what happened yesterday? I want to be conversant in those things. And also, obviously, in my role as a consultant, I'm trying to stay current in all the, you know, the thought leadership that's out there in both the sales and leadership world. So LinkedIn, I found, is a really good place to go do that, along with, throughout the course of the week, the multiple blogs and people that I track with. So I'm reading their material as well.
Good. Well, Kelly, you gave me an idea for a new one of the new tools on our X's and O's segment. But so when you go to LinkedIn, where do you go to get this kind of information?
Well, I'm just going to the news feed typically, and I'm scrolling down and looking. I mean, you know as well as I do, probably better than I do as the guru on the web tools. But there's just so much information that's being now put on LinkedIn, and even people on their regular blog posts and so forth, they're posting those to LinkedIn so that you get them. So I'm working the news stream and working down through those. And then typically what I'll do is I use a tool called Pocket, and I'm sure you're familiar with that. So I'm going to various places that if I don't have time to read the in-depth article, I'm going to save it to Pocket. And over the weekend or when I'm traveling on airplanes, which is fairly frequently as I go to, you know, different clients, then I've got a ready-made reading list there of things that I already know that I'm interested in. And so from there, I'm taking notes and writing down some ideas. And those are the things that trigger a lot of the blog posts and the guest ideas for BizLocker Radio and things like that.
So take us through, you get through that. You kind of have maybe a couple things that really caught your attention. So do you interact right there on LinkedIn with the people that shared those? Do you share them to your followers and connections? Do you go to Twitter? Do you use social media in that way? Or how do you then reach out to your day-to-day business clients?
Well, I do. I share a certain piece of those. And I will say selfishly, most of the time I'm thinking about how awesome that article is and I want to read it. So I'm getting it saved. But there are some things, obviously, that I read that I say, this is things that people want to see. Most of my sharing and my contact with clients comes out of taking those materials that I've saved or notes that I've saved. And so I'm sending an email and saying, hey, you know, I noticed this today and want to make sure you get a chance to see it. Sometimes I'm doing that directly, but a lot of times I want to do it instead of using a LinkedIn mechanism and just sending a message that way. I want to send a more personalized email to specific clients. And so a lot of the clients that I work with recognize that when they get something from me, you know, they know what I've been doing. I've been reading and finding things that relate to what they do on a daily basis and have some pertinence to them. So I like to save those and then use them later and connect in that way. But sometimes clearly in the morning I'll do that. I'll see and go, wow, I'm going to see this guy tomorrow or this afternoon. I want to make sure he sees this before I get there because this is really relevant to what he's doing.
Yep. I love it. I love it. What happens throughout? How do you keep track then of all these things? So this is primarily a morning activity to get up to speed on all of the activity and the thinking for the day, or do you do that throughout the day on your mobile device? Or
yeah, I'll do some of that during the day. You know, typically if I'm at lunch and used to in the old days at lunch we would probably go spend time on a payphone calling our voicemail back in the way old days, at least for me it was. Now you can sit down and eat and actually have your mobile phone and be looking at it. But as I've told a lot of people for a lot of years now, Sunday evening is really the core time for me that prepares my mornings. That Sunday evening after, you know, when the kids were younger and I was in the sales business, after we got the kids to bed, we'd eaten, you know, typically go to church services on Sunday evening, get the kids to bed after dinner and do all that. My wife knew that typically around 8 or 8:30 for a couple hours, I was going to go in the office and shut the door and really plan out my week. And that was my thinking time, Miles. That's when I'm really getting immersed in what am I trying to do and who am I calling on and why, reviewing my sales pipeline and making sure when I'm going to a particular geographical area that I'm hitting all the people that I can get to and making sure my plans are clear. That really has been the driver for me for the last 30 years is typically on Sunday evenings, I'm getting in that cocoon and figuring out what the week looks like. And then Monday morning is sort of that quick touch that makes sure I'm doing the right things and getting the information that we talked about. But I don't think I could do my job very well if I didn't spend some time weekly in that planning process and really having visibility to what my week looks like.
Makes sense, bud. Tell us how people can follow you, how they can find you and learn more about you and your practice, and tell us about your two books real quick.
BizLockerRoom.com. As you well know, almost 2 years ago, a year and a half ago, we've done 80 episodes now of BizLocker Radio. We rebranded my company as the Business Locker Room, and so the URL changed to BizLockerRoom.com. You can find the radio show at BizLockerRadio.com. The two books I've written, One-on-One Management, What Every Great Manager Knows That You Don't. I wrote that just a couple of years after I'd started in practice, and then a couple of years ago came out with Quit Whining and Start Selling, A Step-by-Step Guide to a Hall of Fame Career in Sales. So a book on leadership, management leadership, and a book on sales.
And both of them you can grab, I'm sure. Either just go find Kelly's site and you can find the information and go grab them on Amazon and be able to learn a bunch from a guy that has been in this business and has been very, very successful helping lead other companies, other executives, and other salespeople to success on an ongoing basis. So, Kelly, with that, if you can, I don't even know if you can hear me yet. Can you hear that?
No.
Well, good, because it's a loud fire truck driving by with the fire.
Yeah, I've been warned.
You've been warned. Good. So anyway, that's it. That's going to wrap up the session. I have no clue if anyone can even hear me or anything I'm saying today. But the important thing is they can hear you because I can hear you. So thank you for jumping in. Thank you for joining us. And I hope you have a fantastic day. And I hope we get to catch up with a lot of folks that will see this interview on Mondays on the Biz Locker Room and Biz Locker Radio.
Thanks, man. Great series. Great idea. Can't wait to watch all of them.
Thank you. Appreciate it. Have a good one.
You bet. Bye-bye.